Contact records can be created in CCHI Firm by importing a CSV spreadsheet containing your clients, prospects, leads, and suppliers. This is particularly useful if you have client and contact information exported from another system that you'd like imported into CCHI Firm. The most important things to remember are: contact information can only be imported into CCHI Firm using a file based on a specific template. The template is provided by CCHI Firm. The spreadsheet must be saved as a CSV file. The column headings in the spreadsheet must not be altered from the template. Certain columns of the spreadsheet require very specific information, which will be discussed in this video. To obtain a copy of the CSV spreadsheet template in CCHI Firm, click Settings on the left, then Installation. From this list, choose Import Clients. Near the bottom, click here for a template. There are many columns that can be populated with information. For an explanation of each, use your CCHI Firm Help Center here. Select the link Import Contacts from Another System, and then view the Contacts Preparation Guide here. You'll find information about each column heading. A template with sample information can be obtained from below the Preparation Guide link here. Let's have a look at the template to get an idea of what information to enter. The first two columns, Code and Entity, are the only two mandatory columns that must be populated for each contact. The contact code is used to identify contacts in CCHI Firm. It must be unique for each and every contact. The client code can be a mixture of letters and numbers, but cannot contain most special characters, so please avoid using them. The Entity column determines the type of contact record set up in CCHI Firm. Notice that a record with the entity Individual does not require information in the Name column, but will make use of the Title, First Names, and Last Names columns. A record with a corporation entity will use the Name column, but not the Title, First Names, or Last Names columns. This becomes clear when looking at a contact record in CCHI Firm. A corporation type displays the name field. An individual type displays the title, first name, and last name fields instead. Please note that sole proprietor is like an individual in that title, first name, and last name fields are used. In Settings, Contacts, Entities, you can see default entities that can be read from the spreadsheet and the associated type that will be indicated on the contact record in CCHI Firm. You can add customized entities here, but please note that to link client records with Tax Prep, the default entities must never be altered. Ensure that entities entered in the spreadsheet appear exactly as one of the entities set up in CCHI Firm. A misspelled entity in the spreadsheet will result in a problem with the import. To import properly, the title for individuals and sole proprietors must not end with any punctuation. Now, anything entered in the mailing name column will appear on invoices instead of the names in these columns. Mailing name is also useful for recording the corporate name of a sole proprietor. For partner and manager, names entered in these columns should exactly match partners or managers set up in CCHI Firm. There are CCHI Firm videos that explain how to set up various types of users. Group 1 and Group 2 can be used for creating group filters that can be applied to contacts, jobs, and users, but require setting up in CCHI Firm before information can be imported. Please have a look at the video Firm Filtering and Group Settings to learn more. Contact group allows for contacts to be grouped together for the purpose of single invoicing or group reporting. Postal addressee allows you to identify a name in a corporation contact for correspondence. Breaking up addresses into the various address fields is a best practice, and certainly required if the contact will eventually be linked to tax prep. Make sure that provinces and states are spelled correctly. Ensure that the postal country entered exactly matches any of the available selections in CCHI firm. A salutation, entered as you would typically address the contact, is recommended and must only contain a name and, if necessary, a title. CCHI firm will add the rest of the salutation when generating correspondence. Enter a communication language for any contact. If left blank, the system will default to English. Enter as many phone numbers for the contact as necessary, but note that the work phone is displayed in the main contacts list in CCHI firm. An email address is strongly recommended for each contact to allow for efficient correspondence from CCHI firm. Be sure to accurately indicate the type of record under Client Prospect Lead, as leaving this blank will set the record as Other. If the record represents a supplier, enter Yes in this column. The tax year-end column must only contain the first three letters of a month and will default to December if left blank. Annual accounts month can be useful when operating CCHI firm outside of Canada. For accurate AR and a smooth import into CCHI firm, it is recommended that every contact have a yes or no indicated for charge interest. For those being charged interest, be sure to indicate the period exactly as one of the selections shown here. Also, be sure to indicate the monthly interest rate here to ensure a smooth import of the contact into CCHI firm. If entering a client from or client until date, be sure to only use the format of three digits for the month, followed by a space, then one or two digits for the day, followed by a space, then four digits for the year. Entries to the client type and subcategory fields must strictly follow the North American Industry Classification System, or NAICS, code format. These can be found in Settings, Contacts, Client Types. Copy the type here. Click to see subcategories, and paste the type into the spreadsheet. Any In Business Since entries must follow the standard date format for CCHI firm. Social insurance numbers must be 9 digits and not be duplicated in the spreadsheet or in CCHI firm. Business number entries include the RC number and are 15 characters in length. Enter trust account numbers in the account number field. Date of birth and date of death fields use CCHI firm's standard date format. Invoice statement delivery must contain only either by email or by post, exactly as shown here. Finally, use the physical address fields if different than the postal address for the contact. And there are also fields for another address after that. For a smooth and efficient import into CCHI firm, it is recommended not to exceed 250 records in a CSV spreadsheet. If you have more records than that to import, please split them up to multiple CSV spreadsheets of no more than 250 records each and import the spreadsheets one at a time. To learn how to import your CSV spreadsheets into CCHI firm, please watch the next video in this series, CSV Spreadsheet File Import. If you have any problems or concerns with any CCHI firm process, please contact your Wolters Kluwer Learning Consultant or the Support Center at 1-800-268-4522 or see support at WoltersKluwer.com.